Hi, this is Sean Overton with OneStepRemove.com. In this video, we're discussing fixed fractional money management and how it affects the overall outcome of your trades. Now remember, we're talking about the general statistics, so we're not talking about how it affects one trade. We're concerned about what happens after we've traded 200 or 500 times. Now, when we left off last time, we considered the 50-50 scenario with a one-to-one payout. So we said that we're only going to win half the time, we win a buck, we lose half the time, we lose a buck. We expect the average to come out almost exactly at $100,000, and that's what we found. Within a couple of bucks, we wound up with our original account balance. What we're going to look at in this video is how fixed fractional money management stretches and compresses parts of this curve and how it shifts the probability of the average outcome. But before we get into that, I want to remind you what fixed fractional money management is. It's a complicated name for a simple concept. So with generic trading, most people just risk a fixed dollar amount. They say, I'm going to risk 100 bucks on every trade, or 1,000 bucks on every trade. With this scenario, we're going to risk 1% of our current account equity, regardless of what it's at. So if I start out $100,000, I'm still going to risk 1,000 bucks. But if my account equity grows after that first trade so that it has increased to $101,000, my risk will change very slightly from $1,000 to $1,010. That seems totally trivial, but it has consequences over the long run. And it seems like that really can't add up, but it does. And I want to show you using the software. I'm going to push fixed fractional and calculate that slight difference. And you'll notice some important changes in the curve. So let me go back and show you how the minimum outcome, that's the worst case scenario, you lost almost $46,000, but when you're doing fixed fractional, that improves so that you only lose $37,500. What you've done is you've taken the absolute worst case scenario and pulled it closer to the average. That's a good thing. You're improving your worst case scenario drawdown. Conversely, with the maximum outcome, you see when we're not trading fixed fractional, the maximum was 158,000. If we run fixed fractional, then it improves to 176,000. So you get a $18,000 improvement just by running this. What we've done is we've used fixed fractional to stretch our best case scenario away from the average. That's good. It means that we're increasing profits. Now, before you get carried away and you think, wow, fixed fractional is amazing, I should definitely use it, and I do think you should because of the risk-reward profile, you should understand that it also shifts the average outcome. So you can see here that without doing fixed fractional, you notice that the average outcome 47% of the time was, sorry, I need to rephrase that. 47% of the time you came out below the average outcome. When you do 50-50 odds with fixed fractional, the times that you come out below average has increased by about 5%. What we've done is we've slightly shifted the center. So we've moved a little bit to the left into negative territory, and we've made that slightly more profitable or slightly more probable. But what we've done is we said that when we do win, we're going to win more, and when we do lose, we're going to lose less. I've drawn a sample bell curve and fixed fractional curve to help you visualize this. It's a little hard to display in software, and it's a lot easier just to come up with colors to give you the general concept. The red area represents the losing area, and the green area represents the winning area. The goal is to maximize the ratio of the green against the red. With a 50-50 odds and without doing fixed fractional, you notice that the area is exactly even. This is highly exaggerated, but my goal is to show you how we've changed it. The center line has moved a little bit to the left, so we're slightly more likely to lose just a teeny bit. We've dragged the worst case scenario inward, so we're likely to lose less if we have an extreme series of losses. We've taken the best case scenario and stretched it outward so that if we win, we're going to have a lot more money, and we're dramatically improving the ratio of the green area over the red area. If you have questions about fixed fractional and how it affects the average outcome and the probabilities of different outcomes in your trading, you can find me at www.onestepremove.com. My name is Sean Overton. Thank you for listening.